There have been many parts that I have had to do for this project. Even before we thought about recording Synchron Percussion, I had the challenge to buy all these percussion instruments. That's a dream come true for percussionists or percussion aficionados. It's like being a kid in a toy shop and it gets asked, search for your 200 favorite toys and you can get them all. That's really a dream come true, and it was big pleasure. It took about 2 months. Manix Venenbos helped me a lot to look for the right instruments, especially with drums and cymbals. He knows a lot about these instruments. My ex-teacher from the conservatory, who teaches percussion, Harry Demmer, also helped me a lot with getting the right instruments. About half of the instruments we bought at a big German company called Kohlberg. They not only built lots of instruments themselves, but they also have instruments by other vendors as well. Other instruments where we thought other companies would be the best choice, we got from other vendors or from the companies who manufacture these instruments themselves. I was offered to make the plan for this library, and I made plans which instruments should we record, how many velocity layers, which articulations, and so on. After making all these detailed recording plans, we began work on setting up the instruments in our hall. I had the help of great audio engineers, our chief technician also, Bernd Matzak, and also Markus Wallner and Jörg Meyer, who did a great job in helping me to find the right places of all the instruments, and to find the right microphones and the perfect microphone positions. After the recording sessions have been done, I had to make plans on how all these samples that we recorded would best fit in the product, how they should be mapped, how they can be played with the keyboard and the computer the best and easiest possible way. If I have to say only one, I would say the marimba, because it's such a mellow and warm instrument. It's really, it has a nice tone. It's just a beautiful instrument that's nice to sample. For the marimba, I think it was about a week, 4 days or 5 days for recording the marimba. That may be a bit surprising, but the hardest instrument to sample is, although it may be the most important instrument, it's the timpani. Because when sampling instruments, every sample has to be clean. There shouldn't be any noise. And with the timpani, it's a very complex instrument. There are so many screws. Often it can be that something rattles or makes a little noise, and you always have to get rid of these little noises when sampling instruments. Maybe I would call the taiko. I knew the instrument before, but it was always a traditional Japanese instrument with these very fat and strong beaters. But during the recording sessions, I learned that the sound, if you use tam-tam beaters, is so different to the traditional beaters, and it gives a totally different quality to these instruments. And I guess I even prefer the sound of tam-tam beaters on the taikos, because it brings all the basses and the low frequencies to the forefront, and it gives a much warmer sound to the taikos than the really hard beaters. Fortunately, no one gave really up, but there was one instrument that was especially hard to sample. That's our big Meinl 22-inch piatti. They are called extra heavy, and they are extra heavy. So you have these real big plates, and if you clash them, and then you have to hold them for several seconds, because they sound for 10 seconds or something like that. You always have to put them down for after one hit and pick them up again. And it was impossible to sample this instrument in one go, because you have to be Arnold Schwarzenegger to be able to do that. Yeah, that's really hard. That's harder than playing fortissimo, that's true. Mm. Yeah, because they shake, and you have to just touch the piatti in the right angle, and that's especially hard when they are so heavy. I think this might be the snare drum. It's a totally different world if you play it with sticks or if you play it with brushes. You can tune them in different ways, high or low pitched. You have the top skin and the bottom skin. You can play with these skins with different tunings. And you have the snares. You can have them on, which is the normal snare sound, or you can have them off, which makes it go a little bit more in a tom-tom direction. You can hit the instrument at different places. You can hit it in the center or a little bit off-center, or you can go more to the rim of the instruments. You can play directly on the rim, and all these different things create different sounds. So that's also the reason why we have really lots of different samples for these instruments. I think it's the tam-tam. It can be played very soft, and it has this low and dark sound. If you play a fortissimo roll on the tam-tam, it's louder than all of the rest of the orchestra. So you can play it so loud that you almost don't hear anything else, just the tam-tam. And the sound is totally different if it's played fortissimo in comparison to if it's played pianissimo or piano, because it not only has the low frequencies that are still there, but the louder you play it, the more the high frequencies are added. So if you play it really loud, it's almost like white noise. It has that many frequencies. And what makes it even more complex as far as sound is concerned is that you can play it with so many different beaters and devices. It's not only the tam-tam beaters. You can scratch it with metal beaters or play it with a bow, which all give different worlds of sound. So the tam-tam is also a great instrument for making sound design. And we try to sample this aspect of this instrument as well and made many different sounds. For Synchron Percussion 1, 2 and 3 we have sampled I think it's more than 100 instruments. It's been more than or around 200 days that we have recorded with 6 hours, so really lots of recording time. This number is really impressive. We have sampled around 160,000 samples with 7 microphone positions each, so that's more than 1 million audio files just for Synchron Percussion 1, 2 and 3. Yeah, a great influence on the Western music had the Yanicheris, Turkish warriors. They brought lots of percussion instruments to our Western orchestras, and one famous composer that was particularly impressed by these instruments was Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, and he used lots of percussion instruments to great effect. And one piece that was especially important in this matter is his opera Die Entführung aus dem Serail, where lots of percussive instruments have been incorporated. And then the percussion instruments really became more important only in the 20th century, and maybe even in the second half of the 20th century. One piece that was really important for this development was Ionization from Edgar Varèse, which is a piece for a percussion ensemble which still gets played today. It's a great composition. Yeah, one movie comes to my mind that really impressed me. This movie is not very well known because it's a Swedish independent movie. It's called Sound of Noise. And this features, I think it's 6 percussion players. And they walk through their all-day life and use everything that they see in their life as percussion instruments. And this is a little bit a surrealistic movie, but it's so great and so fun. And everybody who loves percussion instruments will also love this movie, I'm sure about that. And I'd also like to name one of my favorite movie composers. That's John Williams. He's not only a master of orchestration, but he's also a master of orchestration for percussion instruments. I remember one really special situation where we had an earthquake here, and we we almost never have earthquakes in Vienna. Everything was moving a bit and shaking, so the musician asked, what was that? And I said, it felt like an earthquake. But I didn't think that it could really be an earthquake. And then in the evening, I have heard in the news that there has really been an earthquake in Vienna. There's one particular instrument which is just a tiny, small gadget instrument, but it has such a lovely and almost funny sound. And I can show you this instrument. It's the nightingale, and I have brought it with me. I've got it here, and this is what it sounds like.